Get ready to match the stars. Greg Morris, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Barbara Rose, Bill Daly, and Fanny Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Rayburn!
You're Johnny Olson, right? Okay. Hello there. Thank you for joining us. Thank you, too. You're a good bunch. You ready to have a go at it?
Yeah. No.
Would you just stand up for 1 second so everybody can see your new body?
Yeah, isn't
that
nice?
This is the... That's all she can stand up. She's very weak from all her diet. We love your new body.
You want to stand up and see my old body, huh?
No, I don't want to see that.
We didn't want to see it when it was a new body.
What do you say we greet the two players here, Terry Iriard and April Damon. Applause, applause, applause. Terry Iriard's the current champ. She won one game and has a total of $600 to her credit. Ready to carry on?
Yeah.
Okay, you ready to carry on, April?
I am.
We're in the middle of round one. April's had her question. We have one for you coming along in a moment or so. Right now, we have this for you. Here we go. Round one, the middle of round one, we have a Terry Iriart type question. Say, you can tell that Ugly Edna's father is a chef because her face looks like it's been through a blank. That's how you can tell Ugly Edna's father is a chef. Her face looks like it's been through a blank. Face.
I got two of them here. Let me see.
Pick one.
Yeah, pick one. Okay.
All right. Okay, Terry, you can tell that Ugly Edna's father is a chef because her face looks like it's been through a...
Wait a week.
Big
Chuck ain't...
Oh, I saw his light was on. He changed his mind. You can tell that Ugly Edna's father is a chef because her face looks like it's been through a...
Meat grinder.
Good one. Good answer, right?
That is an ugly child.
Yes. You're so ugly.
If her face has been through a meat grinder, the child is ugly. It has been.
A meat grinder. That's an old Johnny Mercer song, isn't it? You're some ugly child. Hello there.
She's shooing the pigeons.
Oh.
And this pipe smoke.
His pipe smoke.
Doesn't he look just like Arthur Godfrey in his prime with that Hawaiian shirt on?
Yes.
Meat grinder.
Oh, that's two for her.
Meat grinder.
Thank you, Arthur. Thank you very much, Arthur. Thank you, Arthur.
You're welcome.
Hello, Barbara.
Hi.
Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Your face looks like it's been through a...
I was going to say Cuisinart, but I didn't know how to spell it.
Me too.
I didn't say meat grinder. I said... Blender.
Blender. Okay. Terry's up to three. Do you contribute to her, Bill?
No, I didn't do too well. I put broiler.
That would be ugly.
That's ugly.
That's a hostile
thought.
That's
a good ugly.
Yes. Miss Sweater Girl?
Yes. I've played 36 rounds. This is the first time I've matched.
Meat grinder. Yay! One, 4-0 is the score. At the end of round one, we go to round two and ask April if she wants A or B.
A, please.
A it is for April. The Burbank Fire Department doesn't own a hose. So when a house is burning, the firemen form a circle around the fire and together they blank on it. No talking. I'll make you stay after school. Hello, April.
Hello, Gene.
The Burbank Fire Department doesn't own a hose. So when a house is burning, the firemen form a circle around the fire, and together they blank on it.
Tinkle on it.
Tinkle.
I'm sorry, Mother.
Hello, Greg.
Oh.
Oh, show us your card.
Tinkle.
There it is. One for her.
I think I misunderstood this question because we never have these kinds of questions. What happens when you ring a doorbell?
Goes tinkle, tinkle, tinkle.
Correct.
Oh, okay.
Oh, what a surprise.
Three for April. Score is now 3-4. What do you say, Barbara?
4-4.
4-4. You make it 5-4.
After drinking all the water from the hydrogen, tinkle.
Right. Fire hydrogen. The fire hydrant. Okay.
Hydrant.
Fire hydrant.
Hydrogen.
Hydrogen.
How'd you take a fire hydrogen?
Yes. What do you say there, Fan?
I just want to say to all my professors at the Pittsburgh Academy of Dramatic Art, thanks a lot.
It's a job, Fanny. It's a job. You're pretending you're having fun up here and all that.
Well,
see?
They told me not to go into the business.
Oh, I see.
They were right.
6-4, the score. You know what you have to do? The best you can do is tie it, and
right.
We'll give you a shot at that right after we give you a shot at this. Pay attention. Okay, here we go. The other round two question for Terry. She must match the two remaining celebrities she has not matched. Barbara.
Are we right?
Oh. And Bill, you are the only two.
Yes.
You are the only two. Are you ready?
I'm still working on what a fire hydrogen is. I'm trying to figure that out.
The smart Alec Hunter said.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Smart.
Oh, I'm sorry. That's how I got the show, by the way. Yes, all right. You notice I used to sit back there? I'm up here. Don't forget tonight, dinner.
No. Yes. No, I'm sorry.
Yes, that's right. You have to be sorry. They all know.
Brett has already spoken for me.
She has? What did she say for you? She said you're going with me. That's what she
no,
said.
She didn't.
She said you could go.
Oh, she did.
She said you could go to dinner with me.
Okay.
Okay, we're going to eat that. Thanks.
Help!
Help!
Next week I'll be in that seat.
You must my hair.
I'm sorry.
The smart Alec Hunter said, if the Lord had intended for elephants to charge, he'd have given them blanks. Smart Alec Hunter. All right.
I think you can still get back into it, Bill.
Whoops. My cable is stuck under your chair.
Oh, I stuck it there. Oh.
Thank you very much. Jump. Okay. All right, Terry. Smart Alec Hunter said, if the Lord had intended for elephants to charge, he'd have given them blanks.
Credit cards.
Credit cards. What else? She said, credit cards.
Well, I'm feeling better already. Credit cards.
Credit cards. There's one. Well, you must match Bill. Stay in the game
I'm
and achieve a tie.
I'm feeling really good already. I said credit cards.
Oh, very good. So, game ends in a tie, which means I have to push the button, and it goes down. Did you hear that? Funny sound. One tie-breaking question for each. The one who's matched the most will be the winner. April, A or B?
A for the third time.
A for the third time.
A for May.
Dumb Donald is really dumb. He figured if the government is selling arms, then he can sell blanks.
Got it.
Ready, Fanny?
Huh? Yeah.
Huh? What? Huh?
Huh? Yes.
That's not a snappy retort. April, Dumb Donald is really dumb. He figured if the government is selling arms, then he can sell blanks.
Legs.
All right. Sounds like a reasonable response to me.
What else but legs?
What else, all right. Yes?
Pants. No, legs.
Legs. Really? Yes.
Oh, what a surprise.
That shirt is really
Hawaiian.
Really Hawaiian, is it? Yes. Thank you, Arthur. Okay, Barbara.
Yes?
If he figured that the government is selling arms and he can sell...
Legs.
Legs? Four for April? You make it five for April?
Do you know what Polish people do with their armies?
What?
They put them in their sleeves.
Oh, what did he say?
Really?
Oh, boy, I'm sorry about that. Ooh, that's a two boo-hiss joke. Legs.
Yeah. Okay. Five for April. Now, Fanny, you don't...
Well, let me explain something.
Yeah.
Now, the first thing I thought of... Now, this is true. I thought if the army was selling arms...
No, if the government is selling arms...
All right, then I thought he would buy them, and they'd have rings on them, and he could sell the rings off the arms.
Her logic is really incomprehensible.
That army
to
joke
me.
Looks pretty good now, doesn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, right.
Army's a sleeves joke.
I just did that.
Okay, so she has five. Terry, you can tie it with five, win it with six. Here we go. Nick said, I have the bull flu. I know it's the bull flu because I have an uncontrollable urge to blank. Would you like to read it?
No.
Have an uncontrollable... Oh, you've got an answer. Bull flu. I have an uncontrollable urge to...
Wait.
Oh, wait.
Okay. A letter to mother.
Nick said, I have the bull flu. I know it's the bull flu because I have an uncontrollable urge to...
Charge.
What else? Bulls charge, don't they, when they're in the ring? What do you say?
Well, you see, I took it a rather bit further.
Hmm.
I said charge a cow. It's the same horsepower.
No, he is not changing his mind.
All right.
That is not a match.
Sorry about that.
Now you must match everyone else to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Terry.
I'm sorry, I said to chase cows.
To chase cows. So that means April wins the game. What do the rest of you have? Hold them up there. Charge, charge. Okay. All right, what have we got there on the carpet? I'll get to you in a moment while you say goodbye to Terry Iriart, who's leaving here with a total of $600.
Thank you very much.
We congratulate Terry Iriart, ladies and gentlemen. We'll spin her off and spin a message or two just for you. Ready? Good. There he is. Okay, John, thank you very much. Here we are with April Damon. She's won her first game. She's going to have a go at the really big money now. Let's see how it works out. We polled a studio audience, April, not too long ago, and said, you write down your best answer to this, if you would, please. Gail Blank. Now, if you give us the answer that they wrote down most frequently, we give you $500. For matching their second most popular answer, we give it $250. And then for matching the third, $100. Three of the six loonies will help you.
I think I'll start with Charles.
Loony number one.
Gail Storm.
Fanny. Okay. Gail, gosh. Let's see, it's six, one, half dozen, the other. Gail, I'm going to go for it. Sondergaard.
You have a Gail loser. Sondergaard is in the audience.
You and that guy, that's the other one.
Yeah. Gail Sondergaard, she's a fine actress. And
that brought an incredible response.
Known by eight people in this world, yes.
I think I'll ask Brett.
Gail Gordon.
Gail Gordon. He plays straight to Lucy. Gail Gordon, you know who he is.
Yes.
Okay, Gail Gordon, Gail Sondergaard. And Gail Storm are the three they've given you. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own.
I'm going to go with Gail Storm.
Gail Storm. Yeah. Gail Storm is what we want, folks. Let's find out if it's up there. May we see the $100 number? Gail Gordon. Okay, there's a good sign. Let's go up the ladder and look at the $250 number.
Gail
Wynn. Wynn. You remember
Who's
her? She was a good actress, too.
She used to be at Warner Brothers.
All right, last chance for Gail Storm. Slide it over. Yes, sir. There was a third actress that you didn't mention.
Who?
She had a John Charles Thomas name, Gail Windstorm. You didn't see that up there.
How about Gail Sayers?
Fifth one down there. Oh.
How about
right.
Gail Sayers?
Gale Sayers? Yeah, there's
sure.
another
Who's
one.
Who's he?
Now, listen, you've won $500. That means the least you'll be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now, you can double your money back here with the Star Wheel. Give it a good hard spin, and we'll see if you double your money. Here it is. She's waited for this moment, she says. And she's spun the wheel. It's made one complete revolution. And we're going to see if it's going to double a little more. And she does double it. With the...
All right, Bill Daly. I've done this show 9,000 times. It's never happened. I never got
happened
this
to you
position.
Before?
No,
it's
never.
It's happening right now.
Oh.
Nothing to us.
Nothing
All right,
all.
You face me if you would, my dear. Here we go. Good luck to you. $10,000.
Excuse me, I got to go to the bathroom.
Come no, not now.
Oh, no, no.
I told you to go before you left the studio. Here we go. Liquid blank. Liquid blank.
Oh, I got to cut that off.
No talking to yourself out loud.
Oh, I'm sorry. Hi, Bill. How's it going? Oh, okay. How's everything going? Oh, okay. Busy.
Okay. If you give us the answer that he's written on the card, we give you $10,000. There it is. Liquid.
Ajax.
I thought I heard someone say liquid Ajax for a second there. Okay. Now, what was your answer?
Should I really repeat it?
Yeah, no. Liquid Ajax, she says. You know, a woman, I suppose, would have that on her mind.
Liquid gas.
Liquid gas. Yes, LP, liquefied petroleum gas. It's a very common substance. What else is there?
Liquid bleach.
Liquid sunshine. Liquid bleach.
Liquid gold.
Okay, a lot of good ones there.
Liquid water.
All right, April, you've got a total of $600, and you're going to meet another player. Let's all welcome Beverly White Wilson. Hello, ladies. Beverly, you know April?
Hello.
Okay, Beverly White Wilson, we welcome you and ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself, if you would, please.
I'm originally from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. I'm an assistant manager to Savings and Loan. I'm married, and I have a beautiful 2.5-week-old grandson.
Yes. Now, you were with us once before.
Yes.
And you had to leave because there was an illness in your family.
Yes.
Everything okay now?
Much better, thank you.
Well, that's good. We're happy to see you back here, Beverly.
Thank you.
All right, good luck to you. We'll start by asking you to make a selection.
A, please.
A, she says. The executioner said, that last prisoner was a showman to the very end. Just before they pulled the switch on the electric chair, he said, and now I'd like to do my impression of a blank.
Honey, I heard it. I heard all the words. It was as though you were speaking in a foreign tongue.
There it is.
Okay, the executioner said that last prisoner was a showman to the very end. Just before they pulled the switch on the electric chair, he said, and now I'd like to do it.
Oh.
What? Say that again.
This is for you. You can have this.
I can't read that. Be careful with that flashing of cards around so people can see him. Okay. Don't do that.
I'm not using this one. I can fly it around.
Oh, you throw that around.
I can throw this around. I'm not using it.
Yeah.
Shoot.
You're finished?
Yes. I put it in there, and I'm going to say
it. All right. Okay. All right, Beverly White Wilson, the executioner said that last prisoner was a showman to the very end. Just before they pulled the switch on the electric chair, he said, and now I'd like to do my impression of a...
dead man.
Okay.
I like that.
Really? Oh, what do you say, Greg?
That's a toughie. I said of a Superman.
A Superman? What happened?
Somebody's tickling me.
Who?
I don't know.
Well, you keep your hands to yourself.
It wasn't
me.
I was tickling you. I was
not. What did you say? Did you show us
it's
your answer?
It's all over. Just come on. There's a speed up sign.
Oh, Superman. And he threw it away.
Right, yeah. You think it's a lousy answer, right? The trick is, yes, we all know. Corpse.
A corpse.
There's one corpse. Yeah.
Charles?
A poached egg.
A poached egg. All right. He's earned his salary for this day. What do you say?
I may not be clever, but I'm right.
Oh, Susan Beverly. What have you got there?
I'm wrong and not clever. I put light bulb.
Light bulb. Oh, that's wonderful. No, that's wrong, but clever. What are you, clever or wrong? Or
I'm
right?
Wrong, clever.
I shouldn't be here. I said... I said, he said, I'm going to do my impersonation of a box of Colonel Sanders fried chicken.
Box of Colonel Sanders fried chicken. All right, that's two for her. You stand by. Now we got this for you. Join us next time for Match Game 78. I'm Gene Rayburn. Thank you all. Tally ho.
Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.